my message to anybody considering coming to Los Angeles, especially during the holiday season, is don't.
A sobering and somewhat terrifying statement from the LA Police Protective League, the union representing LAPD officers. The message coming as a crime wave continues to slam the city and surrounding areas.
We can't guarantee your safety. It is really, really out of control. You know, I said it to people before, it's like that movie Purge. You know, instead of 24 hours to commit your crime, these bad people have 365 days to commit whatever they want.
The warnings seem to resonate with residents.
It's pretty scary walking at night.
Sarah Veenstra moved to LA from Wisconsin about 6 months ago. She didn't realize crime and safety would be such major issues.
I genuinely thought it'd be a safe area. It turned out not to be as safe as I thought. I'm definitely like carrying something on me every single time I walk out of the house when it's dark out.
Rampant crime continues. Some of the latest victims were hit at the downtown Intercontinental Hotel. Three victims were robbed of $100,000 in jewelry early Tuesday morning. Just the latest in a wave of smash and grab. Follow home and home invasion robberies.
Shalom. First thing and foremost, I'm going to give all praises, glory, and honor that's due to Yahweh, Bashim, Yahweh Shai, Bashim, Rakakadash. Double honors to the elders and the apostles, a great millstone, blessings and salutations to the hopeful elect. Real quick, man, purge-like situation out there in Cali. This is going to be all across Babylon and great because of the said measures that's being taken as far as people's livelihoods being disrupted by the pandemic. Mainly you Edomites, okay, you've lived high of the hog, you've been oppressing Jake, and keeping Jake in the most deplorable situation. So now your chickens are coming home to roost. Now you got a bunch of Jakes out there running around LA robbing you damn devils and committing crimes, man. Sooner or later, it's going to be murder and all-out lawlessness across the 50 states of America, a.k.a. Babylon the Great. All right? Why? Because it's Bible prophecy. The scripture said that this will happen in these times we're coming into. So now, you know, brothers, we got to gird up our loins and we got to focus on the prize at hand because this shit is getting ready to be all around us. Even the men of the Lord, we're going to go through certain things, but the Lord is going to see us through it versus these other people. They're just going to be flat out getting put to death. Like the chick on a video talking about, oh, I'm carrying something. They're not going to give a damn about what you're carrying. What you're going to do against 6, 7, 8 hungry Jakes, mob hungry, man. And they come and crack you upside your head with a pipe and then rape you and take your goods. Because that's what's coming to America, man. So it's getting ready to be a lot of loss in this society, man. Deservingly so. Because Jacob's trouble was about loss, man. And about us coming up and gaining. But Jacob's trouble is going to be a very emotional journey for all of us. Because we're going to have family members and people we once cared about is going to get caught up in this very act of tyranny. Why? Because they didn't serve Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai. So we got to gird up our loins and, you know, as they say, put on your big man, you know, your big man shoes and gird up and bite the bullet and deal with what's getting ready to come down. Because it's getting ready to be all hell on earth, okay? And you Edomites, like this detective that was in the interview, he looked like, through the spirit, he looked like he wouldn't, you know, like they hire a lot of these paid agitators to come on these shows and talk all that shit. And reality of it is Esau is behind this whole thing. You know, he paid what they call pay agitators, a crisis actors, like the whole BLM thing. They pay these people to come out and act a damn fool to be justified on spreading chaos. Okay, because in LA, you notice these big Democratic cities are the ones that have the biggest gun bans. And it makes sense that you have the country's largest population outside of New York. You would think that they would have some type of gun laws out there for citizens to protect themselves. But instead, you get caught with a gun, all right? If it's not registered, they'll lock you up. Versus in Texas, you have open carry, okay? Concealed and carry. You don't even need a permit out there. You can just go buy a WAP off the street. And hey, because they need a purge-like scenario. They need all hell breaking loose on earth, okay? So when this shit goes down, and the news broadcasts a cut, 911 is shut down. Hey, man, a lot of people going to end up perishing and you ain't even going to know. I mean, you can have an idea, but regardless of it is, you ain't going to be able to get to these people. All right, so we got to really focus and lock in the spirit and really solely focus on your how about Shimei Havashai, because Jacob's trouble that's not going to be easy to pull through. All right. So right now, brothers, we got to keep our heads in the game. You know, and I'm speaking to myself as well, because we're getting ready to suffer great losses being the men of the Lord. All right. Even brothers will become martyrs in some degree. You know, and that's like a brother, I believe, down in Boston, older brother. He went to the spirit world, I believe, this week or last week. He found him unresponsive in his apartment. You know, older Jake, brother, diligent, you know, older man. And now the Lord called him home, you know. So these things. But anyway, let's get to it. This is the book of Isaiah 13. And I'm going to start at verses 11. It says, "And I will punish the world for their evil and the wicked for their iniquity. And I will cause the arrogancy of the proud to cease and will lay low the haughtiness of the terrible." Okay, who is the arrogant? Esau, the other nations, and the two-thirds, mainly you devils. Okay, like we already said that sooner or later, Jake is going to start going to these neighborhoods of these million-dollar mansions and start breaking in and looting and holding people hostage. Rape, murder. That shit is coming here, man. And don't think Jake can't get in your house. Jake can get in your crib, man. I don't give a damn how technical advantage your bunkers and your security ADA systems are. Jake gonna find a way to get in your shit, man. You know what I'm saying? They showed you on the first Purge movie that ever came out back in 2013, that Jake was running down the street from some people that wanted to purge him. And he made it inside the mansion. The boy let him in. But nonetheless, Jake was in that shit, you know. And if he really wanted to be grimy, he could have taken him out. But he was trying to save his own life. But regardless of it is, you judges, you DAs, you prosecuting attorneys, all you people that put Jake behind bars for petty crimes, you've stole from them, you've made their lives miserable, they're coming to reclaim, okay? They're coming to get their shit, you know? And just our people are wicked in general. So this is just an opportunity for a nigga to be a nigga, all right? But it says here, "And I will make a man more precious than fine gold, even a man than a golden wedge of Ophir." And it's talking about an Israelite man, not some Johnny-come-lately overnight sensation or some type of celebrity. Not no nigga like Nick Cannon, which is getting on the line, grieving the loss of his son. Like, why would you even go on TV with that? If your son died, why would you even, how can you be able to go and broadcast yourself in front of all these people as a publicity stunt? You know, Jake, man, they capitalize off everything, you know, which Nick Cannon, you're done. The Most High is going to take you out. You've already redacted on a fave. You folded. Okay, now you're doing things for publicity stunt. You let the so-called, well, you let the small hat pretty much punk you, man. He punk you. All right? And it says here, "Therefore, I will shake the heavens and the earth shall remove out of our place." And how is the Lord going to do that? Through thermonuclear destruction. It says, "In the wrath of the Lord of hosts and in the day of his fierce anger, and it should be as a chased roe." And that's how you Edomites are going to be. Okay? Like when you see a deer in the headlights and it just peels off, or if you chasing a deer, man, they get gone, they get ghosts. And that's what a roe is a deer. So you Edomites, man, out of all the guilt you've put on our people, you're guilty, okay? And you feel some type of way because now your judgment is coming back full swing. So therefore, when you see Negroes and so forth, you try to help them out. But regardless of it is, you know that they're coming for that head. You know that they're coming to get you. So therefore, hey, man, you're going to be like a chase roe out here, you know? It says, "And they should be as the chase roe, as a sheep that no man take it up," right? Because, hey, you're going to be abandoned. No other nation is going to come to your defense when you Edomite men and women and kids are being judged. Nobody's coming to your defense because the whole world hates you, all right? Nobody's coming to your defense only but the fucking black woman. And the black woman, she's just going to get mowed down like the beast she is if she stands in the way, all right? But other than that, the Lord is not going to deliver you from this, Esau. This is your judgment. Okay, right along with the two-thirds of these grimy-ass Jakes. And it says here, "And they shall every man turn to his own people, and everyone flee into his own land. And everyone that is found should be thrust through, and everyone that is joined into them shall fall by the sword." Okay, so any of you Jakes out there that want to help this damn devil out of his condition, guess what? You're going to be put in disarray right along with him. All right, you're going to be destroyed right along with Esau. Because we've warned you, Jakes, hey, you're not supposed to join hand in hand with the wicked. You think that this devil, if it was his choice of defending you, you think he gonna defend you? And he totally just set you black woman up, because he's giving you basically almost a band a month to do your bullshit which is going to cause you to let your guard down, and you're going to be a primary example of Revelation 13 and 16 and Revelation 14 verses 9 and 10. You're going to be destroyed, man. All right. So, yeah, the purge, man, this is going to be the real deal. All right. Jake is going to come in these neighborhoods and they're going to start, like they said, they've got robbed for hundreds of thousands of dollars in jewelry. So they're going to hotels. They're going to homes, neighborhoods, and they're not regarding the cops. They don't care. All right. Isaiah 19:2, and I will set the Egyptians against the Egyptians, and they shall fight everyone against his brother and everyone against his neighbor, city against city, kingdom against kingdom, and the spirit of Egypt shall fell in the midst thereof. And that's talking about this whole continent, because America, Babylon the Great, aka Egypt. And I will destroy the council thereof, and they shall seek to the idols and to the charmers and to them that have familiar spirits and to the wizards, right? Because they're going to inquire about what's happening from these particular soothsayers, these prognosticators, man, these particular leaders. They're going to ask for help and governance so they can get back to what they call a normal society. But things are going to be so chaotic to the point that nobody's going to come to the beck and call. And this is prophecy. All right. So this is the book of 2 Kings 15:56. It says, it's like as thou has always done to my chosen, says the Lord, even so shall the Most High do unto thee, and should deliver thee into mischief. Right. Because you're getting delivered into derision now. Okay, you're going to see what it's like to be the new Negroes on the planet, not having anything, being robbed and hunted and spoiled every way. Jake can't go around the corner without the cops harassing him, man, or getting gunned down. You know, Jake, man, this is pure hell. You know, Jake is dropping dead due to high blood pressure, diabetes, the WAP, the jab. Jake, man, we can't catch a break here. This is why we need the kingdom, because in the kingdom, we're never going to die again. We're going to be eternal. All Israel, you know, but you other nations, you heathens, you're going to have life as normal. You're going to be basically mortal men and women. You're going to give up the spirit and go back into the spirit world and come back. So reincarnation is going to be in the kingdom too, because most of the Jakes that die on this side are going to be reborn in the kingdom if the Lord don't raise them up to be judged again a second time, which is very possible for you wicked ass Israelites. And it says, and thy children shall die of hunger, and thou shalt fall through the sword, and the city shall be broken down. The purge, man. All right? Because the cities are going to be broken down to the point they're going to have to deploy the United States military, or the military. I won't even say the U.S. because among you're going to have some U.S. troops out here, but majority of them, they ain't already croaked from the you know what. They're going to be shipped off to the Middle East. And the ones that didn't go AWOL to join these civilian militias. But the United States military is going to be pretty thin. This is the reason why they're going to have to reinstate another draft, possibly. You know what I'm saying? But other than that, you're going to have blue hats on the street. Okay, and the blue hats ain't going to play with you people. They're not called the peacekeepers for nothing. Okay, because how do you constitute peace? By eliminating the threat. Okay, and you people are considered a threat. Okay, and it says here, in the city should be broken down, and all thy shall perish with the sword in the field. Okay, your little suburbs, your little countries, your different plush parts of the world, you're going to perish. And it says, and they that be in the mountains should die of hunger and eat their own flesh. Right, cannibalism is coming back in a big way. And the city should be broken down, I read that already, and drink their own blood for the very hunger of bread and thirst of water. And thou, as unhappy, should come through the sea and receive the plagues again. So this shit is getting ready to crack, man. You know what I'm saying? Whoever... It's getting ready to go down, man. Okay. 2 Kings 15, and I'm going to start at verses 15. It says, for the sword in their destruction draweth nigh. One people should stand up and fight against another, and swords in their hands. For there should be sedition among men, and invading one another, and they should not regard their kings nor princes. And the course of their acts shall stand in their power. Meaning they're not going to give a damn about what de Blasio said, what Kumo said, what what's this Beetlejuice. Lori Lightfoot, that whatever the hell that is, that ET looking bitch. They're not gonna give a damn about none of you damn people. If anything, they're gonna be seeking to kill you too. Which, you know what, I wouldn't even be mad if one of you, if somebody caught you and, you know, whatever, man. You get the point. You people are wicked, and the Lord is gonna allow you to be judged. I'll say it that way. All right? And us as the men of the Lord, we're gonna sit back and we're gonna watch it. And we're gonna enjoy it. Because, hey, this is the Lord's vengeance. Okay? This is the time we've been waiting on. So we got to gird up our loins, because we're going to see a lot of judgment and death right before us. Like the scriptures say, 10,000 shall fall by thy left, 1,000 by thy right, but it should not come near thee. So we got to be prepared to stomach a lot of death, man. All right. And the biggest hurdle in that situation will be your family members getting destroyed in this situation. Because I'm going to tell you straight forward. I'm going to cut it straight. Most of our families are going, they not going to make it. Majority of them not going to make it, bro. And that's just real talk. You know what I'm saying? You'd be lucky if you were close to them, they croak before this shit happens. But majority of them going to get caught up in what's happening. Okay, you know what I'm saying? Like I said, I lost my uncle last night, which I believe he was dead since Tuesday. But, you know, Esau, he wants to experiment. But, you know, Lord sent him to the spirit world. But then, you know, I still got a grandmother. I got an auntie. I got cousins. I got a mother. I got sisters. I got brothers. You know what I'm saying? I got a child. All these things I had to be prepared to lose for this truth. You know what I'm saying? And brothers, likewise, you know, brothers go through this all the time. So we got to really put our mind in the reality. Like, some brothers lost both parents. You know, I know a brother that lost both his parents within a couple of years, you know, a couple of years apart. That's not an easy pill to swallow, especially when you in this truth and you got to do the work. But if you understand the scriptures, you know that the scriptures say that everybody must make an account for what he's done in the body, good or bad, to stand before the judgment seat. And we ultimately know you're an Israelite, you go to the spirit world, the Lord's good, he's taking care of you, you're going to be straight. That's the comforting thing about it, you know. A lot of times we're bugged out over the memory we had of the person, but the person or the spirit in the spirit world is good. They good. You know, they like, shit, y'all crying over me. Y'all, I'm the one that should be crying over y'all. Y'all getting ready to go through this craziness. But regardless, man, we got to keep pushing. It says, for because the pride, the city should be troubled and the houses should be destroyed, afraid, and men should be afraid, and a man should have no pity on his neighbor, but should destroy their houses with the sword and spoil their goods because of the lack of bread and great tribulation. So, hey, Esau, Jake is coming to your hood, bro. You better get locked and loaded because Jake is coming for you. They coming to collect. And not only Jake, all these other nations too. And you're going to have Edomites that's on the prowl too. Esau is coming to collect on Esau too. It's going to be just an all-out fucking battle royal in America. And we the prophets, we're going to sit back and witness it. So, hey, if you ain't right, you better get right and fast. And with that, all praises and glory and honor that's due to Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, Shalom, Wa Ababa Ba.